A first-of-its-kind study finds electric cars are having a positive impact on respiratory health. Joining us live to talk more about it is the study's author, Dr. Erika Garcia, with USC's Keck School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor. Thanks so much for joining us.
Good morning.
Well, we know EVs are better for the planet, but your study is really the first to make a definitive link between zero-emission vehicles and health. Tell us more about what you actually found.
So we took advantage of this, you know, natural experiment that's occurring here in California, this early stage of the transition to EVs. And we wanted to see how this increasing number of electric vehicles and other zero emission vehicles is associated with air pollution as well as asthma related ER visits. And first, we found that there was this remarkable growth in EVs during the 7-year study period. But importantly, we saw that there was this considerable difference. There's a considerable slower growth in EVs among zip codes that have lower social economic status, which we're terming the adoption gap. We found evidence that those zip codes with greater increases of EVs during this time had greater declines in asthma ER visits, you know, even after controlling for these differences in social economic status and the overall trend in time of the outcome. And then for air pollution, the results were a little bit more modest, but we did see suggestive decline in an air pollutant, nitrogen dioxide, that was related to the increasing EVs.
Well, doctor, you know, previous studies have found that, you know, the relationship between smoking and things like heart disease and lung problems, but where does your research really fit in when it comes to the link between environment and health? Let's talk more about that.
Yeah, so air pollution is a big concern in thinking about environment and health. And there has been a lot of research that is linking traffic-related air pollution specifically to a range of adverse health outcomes, including death. Speaking about electric vehicles, there has been a large number of projections that this transition to EVs will improve air quality and health, but these have been projections. And so we used observed real-world data to show this link between health and air quality as co-benefits of the EV transition, even really in this early phase of transition here in California.
And you mentioned EV use is less prevalent in lower income areas and among people without college degrees. Talk to us about how, you know, communities can, or what they can do actually to increase EV equity and affordability and better health outcomes in these areas.
Yeah, so you're right. This is an important environmental justice issue. You know, we saw this striking adoption gap, which really does threaten the equitable distribution of co-benefits of this transition to EVs. And this is especially important because these communities tend to be overburdened with traffic-related air pollution to begin with, as well as the adverse health consequences of exposure, like asthma. And policies that promote the transition to EVs, you know, could focus on underserved communities that are already experiencing these greatest burden of traffic-related pollution, as well as, you know, the health consequence of it, such as asthma ER visits. And you could think about, you know, climate change is one of the greatest public health threats of our time, but it is also, and climate change mitigation is also one of the greatest public health opportunities, especially for these most vulnerable communities.
All right, Dr. Erika Garcia with USC's Keck School of Medicine. Thank you so much for the insight.
Thank you. Well.